Okay, so looking at the previous videos, we talked about utilizing Boyle's Law and not including temperature, because Boyle's Law doesn't include temperature. It considers temperature as being a constant, not changing. So we talked about using this formula, the P2 equals P1 times V1 divided by V2. And we had that balloon that was at the surface that was 50 cubic feet, and then we lowered it into the water to 99 foot, and it shrunk it down to 12.5. So I want you, I'm keeping these numbers up here, because when we actually do Lusak and Gray Lusak and Charles's law, which it expands on Boyle's law and adds temperature in in regards to a Rankine, the absolute temperature, you're gonna see on how much more volume is lost because of the temperature, okay? All right, so what is this gonna do? Why is this important? Because we wanna actually showcase that showcase that temperature also is going to affect the volume of the item that you have in the water. And the colder it is, the more it's going to shrink, and the hotter it is, the more it's going to expand. So for instance, before we go into the formulas, I've got my sun out here, which means that this is at the surface, and at the surface it's 100 degrees Fahrenheit, and at 99 foot it's really cold, it's 50 degrees Fahrenheit. So I'm going to show you on how this 50 degrees in temperature is going to affect the volume. The volume, maybe not by a lot, but it's still going to affect the volume. Okay, so we're going from 50 cubic foot to 12.5 cubic foot using Boyle's Law, considering temperature as a constant. Okay, so going into the formula again. So the rule here is, if we want to convert Fahrenheit to Rankine, we just have to take the Fahrenheit degrees and add 460, so we automatically have that. Okay. So before we go on any further to the formula, let's do that real quick, okay? So let's say we're gonna be using this. Why this? Because I'm able to tell you that the degrees at the surface, out of the water, we're at 100 degrees Fahrenheit. So what do? We take 100 and we add it to 460 to come up with Rankine, or the absolute temperature. So this is gonna be, so that means that T1 is going to be 560 Rankine, okay? Now, we come over here to the bottom, and we're at 50 degrees Fahrenheit. So what are we gonna do? We're gonna take 460 plus 50, which is 510. So this is gonna be 510 Rankine, okay? So now, we have pretty much figured out T1 and T2. Now, why are we having to convert to Rankine? Because these mathematical formulas require absolute temperature. The only two absolute temperatures that are available to you are not Fahrenheit, and they're not Celsius, they're Rankine or Kelvin. And we're using Rankine because predominantly in the United States we use Fahrenheit, okay? All right, so this is a done deal. Now we know why, and we automatically figured it out. We took our thermometer and we figured out that it's 100 degrees Fahrenheit at the surface, and then we also measured the bottom, and at the bottom is 50 degrees Fahrenheit. We converted to absolute temperatures. So now we literally have T1 and T2 done, okay? Now, looking at the setup again, we're gonna be going to 99 foot of water, which means that what is our ATA down there? Same ATA, 4 ATA, all right? And we have a balloon, and the balloon size is gonna be the same. It's gonna be V1, volume is gonna be 50 cubic feet. Same balloon. So now we got V1, T1, T2. We are looking for what the volume of it is of the balloon as soon as it goes down and gets to 4 atmospheres or 99 foot. So that means we're gonna be looking for what? V2, right? P2, what is P2? What is the pressure? 4 ATA, there you go. And what is the pressure at 1 atmosphere? 1 ATA. Okay, so we got the T's, we got the P's, and we got 1 V. So we're gonna be looking for what? V2. So look at the formula setup. P1, P2, V1, there you go, V2 right there. This is the formula we're gonna be utilizing right here. Okay, so we've got V2 equals P1. What is P1? 1 atmosphere, 1 ATA, 1 ATA. Okay. And then it's going to say times T2. What is T2? 510. And then it's going to say times V1. What is V1? 50 cubic feet. Divided by P2, what is P2? P2 is 4 atmospheres. Times T1, what's T1?
560.
Okay, so now we're going to take all that one and figure out what happens. Let's see here. 1 times 510 times 50 is 25,500. Okay. We're going to say 4 times 560. 240. 25,500 divided by 2240. The answer to this is 11.38 cubic feet. Okay? So, no temperature, 12.5 cubic feet. Very cold temperature, 11.38. So you've literally lost 1 cubic foot. So it's very, very important for you to be able to know, because if you have a cylinder, that cylinder is going to decrease in volume, or whatever volume you have down there is also going to decrease, and if you need to compensate for it, you need to know that. So that means that Gay, Lucas, and Charles's law is way more advanced than Boyle's law, because now it incorporates temperature. Now you can actually figure it out for anything in regards to volume or pressure. So you can use it the same way as you did Boyle's law. But it shows you right there, if you utilize Boyle's law and you negate or you don't use temperature, your cubic footage is 12.5. In actuality, temperature does play a big role, and you decrease it by literally one cubic foot, or a little less than 1 cubic foot as well. So this is an example of also the general gas law. So the combination of Gay, Lucas, and Charles, and Boyle's is a combination of all the different formulas, the way that you can utilize them, which is the general gas law, which is known as P1 times V1 divided by T1 equals P2 times V2 divided by T2. And the V's and the P's and the T's, you know where all those mean. And you know that you need to be using absolute temperature, and you know what Rankine and Fahrenheit how it's translated to Rankine. So that would be a perfect example of showing you how temperature does play a role with the volume of an object. And that's about it. So that's the general gas law.